Hello, everybody. Welcome to Disney's Hollywood Studios. Disney is celebrating Pride the entire month of June, which means there are all sorts of delicious, colorful treats to be found at all the parks and all the locations. And so today we want to go around Hollywood Studios and try every single one of the brand new rainbow, colorful, delicious treats. They look awesome and I cannot wait to try them. First treat we are on the lookout for is at Rosie's All-American Cafe. It's usually burgers at that location, which is pretty good. Pretty good spot for grub down here by Tower of Terror. Now, we've kind of been looking at the wait times today before we got here and noticed that a couple of the rides have been down. So Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway have been down most of the day. Rock and Roller Coaster's been down. Tower of Terror has been at about 150-minute wait. Wow. That is crazy. I believe one side is still not operating, which is causing these longer wait times. So I think instead of four elevators running, they've only got two running. So I don't think we're going to be riding Tower of Terror, quite honestly, for a long time until that gets fixed, because I'm not waiting 150 minutes for that. Rosie's All-American is right up here on the left, kind of over by Catalina Eddie's. Now, if you watched our video yesterday, you heard us talk about the tropical storm that was on its way to Orlando and was supposed to hit here today. Well, I am proud to show you the tropical storm that is happening right now. Yeah, not so much. It pretty much just hasn't really come that much here. I don't even think it's rained a drop yet here in Orlando. And the day's almost over, so now there have been a few clouds in the area on and off all day. We've kind of seen them floating around. I mean, it's not a beautiful blue sunny sky right now. It's just kind of overcast, but like I said, it hasn't rained, and I do think that if it does rain, it'll just be for a few minutes and it'll probably be light. This is why we always say, like, don't plan your Disney vacations or trips around weather. Just don't do it. I mean, it just doesn't make sense. Enjoy it. Like, plan it for when you feel like you want to be here. Don't even look at the weather. Just come. Bring ponchos. Be prepared. But for the most part, just be here. Don't worry if it says it's going to rain or there's a hurricane coming. Even when there's a hurricane, it's here for literally a couple of hours on one day. And then it's gone. Now, if you see a tropical depression, that means that it's one of these, like, tropical storms that doesn't move and just sits. And that can sit for days and days and days. But that's very, very rare. I would just not even really pay attention and just show up. And we've been here during the tropical depression and we still had tons of fun because it wasn't like downpouring. It was just kind of overcast and slightly rainy the whole time. So it ended up being like nobody was even in the park. So anyhow, just some advice. We just picked up our Pride Cheesecake Dome and I would explain to you what's in it, but unfortunately, when you look on the actual menu, the explanation for it is not correct. The actual explanation is a vanilla cupcake. Huh? So I think they have the wrong description. They have the right picture and the right name, but they have the wrong description in the actual mobile order app. So I have no idea what's in this thing. This cupcake, I know, is actually something we're gonna be trying next, which is over at the ABC Commissary, I believe. So it's interesting, it's funny to me that they have the wrong description. They have the description for that cupcake on this dome. I have no idea. So, can't wait to try this thing. I mean, it looks pretty solid. Check it out. Look how cute it is. I mean, look at all the sparkles. I mean, it has all this like sparkly sheen to it. And it's got these cute little rainbow ears, this little Mickey Mouse dome. I think this is maybe like some sort of cookie on the bottom. I'll be honest, whenever there's been some sort of weird graham slash cookie thing on the bottom in the past on these things, because they sit them in the fridge, they're like mush. Not crisp at all, they're mush. So I'm a little bit concerned about it. But let's just rip into it because I want to try it and I love cheesecake.
Do we even know if it's cheesecake?
It's called Cheesecake Dome, so I'm assuming it's cheesecake. It looks like it has some sort of like strawberry or raspberry mousse looking thing in them, or cream cheese mousse, I'm guessing, in the middle. Yeah, give it a go.
I'm going to eat the cookie part separate. And as predicted, the cookie part is very mush. Got sparkles on my finger now.
I like it. It's not like the best thing I've ever had, but
it is good. Yeah. I'm trying to see if I can get the cookie and the mousse now. Can't get it off for some reason.
I think it's good.
Yeah.
But I love cheesecake. So, and I love crust. It's not a crispy crust because they do put it in the fridge. But this, I like this a lot better than I thought I was going to.
What?
I keep eating it.
What flavor do you think the cheesecake is?
Let me try one more time. I think it's strawberry.
Strawberry?
That's why I like it. It might be raspberry, but I feel like it's strawberry. That's good. And I love strawberry cheesecake, so.
I think it's strawberry. I like the cheesecake better than the crust thing. I'm actually just kind of, now at this point, eating the cheesecake stuff off the crust and not eating the crust.
I like it all.
The crust doesn't have that much flavor, I don't think. And I don't like the texture. It's just, I mean, it's kind of just like sand. It's got like a texture of sand. It's kind of grainy. Well, it was glued on here.
I just got it all over the table.
Yeah. She tried to get it.
Yeah, and it was actually glued.
This is why we couldn't get it off. This is odd. So, I don't know if you can see it on there. Let me see if I can get it.
I have it everywhere.
Like right here, there's this like glue.
Yeah.
On the thing it was sitting on. So like, while it looks cute, like nice and displayed and everything, like it's physically, it is
you
actually like glued on. So we kept trying to like get the crust and it, I was like, and it wouldn't come off. And then she finally was like trying to dig
flip
a piece of crust off it. This is what I saw. I saw this, it was like flip. Onto the table.
Yeah.
So we're not eating that piece.
No.
So again, I really dig the cheesecake. I could have done like a big portion of that cheesecake stuff and skipped the crust, but she really liked the crust.
Yeah.
So overall, it's pretty good. This was $5.99.
Yeah.
This is one of the better desserts that we've had, especially at Rosie's All-American. Rosie's All-American usually has like a big cookie, like a big Mickey-shaped cookie, and I don't think their Mickey-shaped cookies are that good.
I like their pumpkin cookies.
Pumpkin one was probably the best of all the ones we've had there. But I feel like most of them are just kind of like plain.
Yeah.
So it's a good welcome change to the big cookie there. When I saw Rosie's All-American, I thought for sure it was going to be another busted cookie. But it ended up being cheesecake, so I was like, we're dead. We got to try that.
Yeah.
So let's head over to ABC Commissary now and see if they have the cupcake or not. Sometimes they run out, so I want to see if they have it. And then there's one other item I think we definitely want to try too, and then whatever else we can find. So let's get moving. I don't know if you can see it on the ground or not, but just as I was saying a minute ago that it hasn't even rained a drop during this tropical storm, while we were doing the video for eating the cheesecake dome, it actually started sprinkling pretty heavily for about 60 seconds and then stopped. And now the sun's out again. So, yep, that's Florida. Let's do a quick walkthrough of the Once Upon a Time. See if there's anything interesting in this store. Haven't actually been in here for quite a bit. Yeah, that's cute. So far, most of the same merchandise that I see in the Disney Springs store at World of Disney. I see some Pizza Planet underwear for anybody who might be interested for $19.99. Yeah, that's funny. The only thing I noticed here new is kind of these ears right here. I haven't seen these ears before, and I don't really know what they're supposed to be. I really have no idea. I've looked at them and I can't figure out what they are supposed to be other than just kitchen and flowers or something. I don't know. So we noticed that they have these 4th of July Americana sort of ears here, celebrating the United States. Doesn't have a price, but I think they're, what were they, $29.99, I think? $29.99, they're very cute. Which is making us think that potentially these ears here, which I didn't know what they were, now that we see the sort of 4th of July, I'm thinking maybe this is like 4th of July apple pie, Americana, picnic-y type ears. I'm going to assume that's what this is, but honestly, without the context of the American flag, it kind of falls flat for me, but if you like them, there they are. I'm going to assume they're the same price, $29.99, as the USA ears, so.
Although they really shouldn't be, because the USA ears embellished with all kind of sequins, and these are not. They're just more kind of like a, just kind of a cheap fabric, actually.
Yeah.
But I'm not saying they're not cute, but I think they should be cheaper than the sequins ones. My opinion.
Yeah.
We were in luck. ABC Commissary had the cupcake, the Pride cupcake. I'm excited. And when I went to order it, so the description for the Pride cupcake was also wrong. It was actually switched. So when I was reading the description for the Pride cupcake, I was like, wait a minute, that sounds a lot like the Cheesecake Dome. Yeah, good job, Disney. You switched the description on both of them. Check it out. You read that? Pride cupcake.
Was it strawberry?
So I'm gonna read. So let me read what's in the Cheesecake Dome, since we didn't have that description. So it said it was a whipped berry, just says berry, doesn't say strawberry, or maybe it was a combination, like a mixed berry. Whipped berry, white chocolate cheesecake with a rainbow sparkle, graham cracker cookie glazed with a red, white chocolate shimmer mirror glaze. That was a lot. Topped with Mickey Pride ears. So that was it. So we still don't know if it was strawberry or raspberry. It was probably strawberry, maybe with a slight mix of other berries in there. So, show the Pride, I mean, we already saw it in the picture, but show it anyway. Yum. You were doing a little dance?
Yeah.
I was excited when I saw this because when I read the description, I thought it sounded so good. Let me read it off, okay. Vanilla cupcake. Cool, vanilla cupcake. Filled with rainbow sprinkles and a berry marmalade. I don't know. I guess there's some sort of berry marmalade on the inside of this thing. But then I saw topped with a red berry buttercream. I'm a sucker for buttercream. I love good buttercream.
Yeah, but I feel like a lot of times buttercream things say it's going to be buttercream, and it's definitely not.
It's definitely not. It's like wedding cake icing.
And this doesn't look like it is, so we'll see.
Yeah, it's like wedding cake icing, which is basically just like,
I don't like wedding cake icing.
I don't want to say what's in it, but basically it's just powdered sugar and like fat.
Yeah.
For lack of a better word. But I still love it. And it says garnished with rainbow sprinkles, rainbow glitter, and Mickey Pride ears. And this was also $5.99. I'm excited. I love cupcakes. We've said this before. I love cupcakes, especially a good cupcake. This is going to take some. This is going to be one of those things that takes work to get into.
Yeah.
I already know how this is going to go. So let's try to get it open.
And I'm going to let him, because the icing's red, which means it'll probably die.
It's already getting on my hand.
Red. So.
Open sesame! Oh my.
That's why I didn't want to do it.
I haven't even made any progress on opening this thing, and I've already gotten icing on my hand twice. Let's see if we can do something here. No, that's not working either. Okay, here, I got it. I started ripping it. Now we're getting somewhere. Yeah, okay, this is super messy. Okay, back on the plate it goes. It's trying to be cutesy. But it's going to have to go back on this plate. Wow, this is a train wreck. Well, we're getting somewhere. Let's just set that aside. Okay, okay, let me just see if I can get it out of here. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, there we go. All right, we're going to have to try to cut this thing. I think taking a bite of this is just going to be too difficult. Let's see what happens here. Cut. Okay, there is a little bit of, not very much though, really, in there. Marmalade. I mean, it looks pretty good. There's a lot of buttercream on that.
I mean, that is a lot of buttercream. Holy cow, look at that. I don't know how I'm going to get all this in my mouth, but there was nothing else there. It is what it is.
It's hard not to get the red all over you.
It really is.
I thought I was doing well. I wasn't. It's all over me.
Interesting.
I like the taste of the marmalade.
Yeah. What do you think?
The icing is not buttercream. I do not like it.
I'm actually
at all
shocked at how there can be so much buttercream, quote unquote buttercream, and marmalade and sprinkles on this, and yet it still tastes like it with not like that much sugar.
Yeah.
I felt like I put almost an entire glob of almost flavorless whipped cream in my mouth.
Yeah, and it definitely doesn't taste like buttercream. I'm not even sure why they advertise it that way. I knew it wasn't going to be by looking at it. It's not. It's the same icing they have on all the cupcakes in Disney.
No, I feel like it's a little bit different.
Do you?
Yeah.
No, I don't like it. I like the marmalade in the middle, though. That was good.
I am not even joking when I say I feel like there's not even a kernel of sugar in that buttercream. It has a little berry flavor, like a slight berry flavor to it. No butter flavor whatsoever. No sugar flavor whatsoever. It honestly just tastes like a lightly berry flavored whipping cream, which is not good.
No.
That's not a good flavor. But the cupcake and the marmalade are good. The cupcake itself is actually solid. The vanilla cupcake has a good flavor. It's a little sugary. The marmalade tastes good.
It tastes like strawberry. Is that what it said it was? Or was it raspberry?
I think it said, I don't know. I don't remember. I already forgot. Some sort of berry. But I like the marmalade and the cupcake. The whipped cream's terrible.
Yeah.
It's really, I don't understand. The texture of the whipped cream's cool. It's like a whipped cream.
And he's calling it whipped cream, but it's supposed to be icing. Tells you anything?
You're right. I didn't even realize. Yeah, because it's whipped cream.
Yeah.
It's not icing.
I feel like it's all over my face.
So do I. I feel like my face is red. My teeth are going to be red. It just doesn't taste like, it's not even like that good. You know, like some cakes, what is it? Like, some of like the fat, like the retail, what am I talking about? Like,
I don't know.
Grocery stores. You know, it's like some big chain grocery stores have like those cakes or cupcakes that have that like whipped cream type icing on them. It's not like the standard icing. It's like this like whipped cream type icing. And those are actually pretty decent. Still not my favorite type of icing. I prefer like normal icing, but like a lot of people like that whipped cream icing. This isn't even that. Like it's not, it doesn't even, it just has no flavor. Yeah. Shocking. You saw how much I was like, man, there's a lot of buttercream. It was like huge, like this huge stack of buttercream. And then I got this huge scoop and I was like, I don't even know how I'm gonna, like this is about to be so rich that I'm not gonna be able to even, I'm gonna go into a sugar coma. And I put it and I ate it, nothing. Like almost no flavor at all. $5.99 for this as well, by the way. The same price as the dome. The dome was better.
Get the dome, don't get this.
The dome was better. Yeah. Yet another disappointing cupcake from Disney.
They like the cupcakes.
They don't know how to make cupcakes at Disney. I'm just going to say it. They really don't. I am an expert in making cupcakes.
He is good at making.
Everybody loves my cupcakes. Yeah. I'm just going to say it. You should let other people tell you they love your cupcakes.
they do.
Yeah, no, they really do.
Yeah.
So, Disney, I know you watch. If you want to know how to make good cupcakes, give me a call. Because your cupcakes are not good. They're horrendous. I don't think we've ever had a good cupcake. Maybe.
No, every time we're going to get one, I'm like, not that again.
Yeah, maybe we've had like a decent cupcake, but most of them are just, they're just slightly off. Like if it just had a little bit something else, they'd be really good. They're just always a little bit off. So
they're a waste of money.
Disappointing. Moving on. So let's go and check out our third item if it exists. If not, just like yesterday, we'll call an audible. We're gonna head over to our third spot. We're walking by the Sci-Fi Dine-In restaurant. There's always a lot of people waiting for this restaurant. It's usually pretty crowded. We just did a review of the Sci-Fi Dine-In restaurant. It's really not one of my favorite restaurants at Hollywood Studios, but it's okay.
Baseline Tap House is a great place to stop for some snacks and drinks. Unfortunately, this next location, there's really just no easy way to get there from where we just were. We kind of have to like almost walk around the entire park to get there. We really need to fix that. There used to be a nice little kind of walkway right over here to the right that you could kind of skip through, cut to, but it's gone now, unfortunately. Coming out of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge behind us here. Unfortunately, that was the quickest route to our next stop. We had to walk through the entire Star Wars Galaxy's Edge just to get over to Toy Story Land for our third stop, which is going to be Woody's Lunchbox. We need to eat at Woody's Lunchbox again. They got good grilled cheese there. Really good. Yeah, I don't even like barbecue. Same. And it was good. We need to try it. We need to go there and eat again. See, I'm starting to wonder why we're not just going to eat there now. Starting to get pretty hungry, and we had so much sugar, I need something like salty. Something hearty. But that's not going to be this next thing. I was like walking through Toy Story Land. I think it's really cute. I think it's even cuter at nighttime. But I do like how it makes you feel like you're kind of like shrunk down to a toy size. And it's all colorful. Woody's Lunchbox has an interesting fried dessert that we wanted to give a try, so let's hop in here and grab it real quick. Woody's Lunchbox. Let me just talk a little bit about Woody's Lunchbox, because the same experience that we've had every time we've tried Woody's Lunchbox, we had again today, which is when we go to mobile order. So every other location that we mobile order, it's usually pretty quick.
Yeah.
Like you just, it, like the window is like from now till like a certain time period.
Yeah.
And it's usually pretty quick. Every time we come to Woody's Lunchbox, it's always like 30 to 45 to even like an hour or even an hour and a half window before the window even starts. So it'll be like if it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon, it'll say return time 2:30 or 3 to like 4 or 3:30, and I'm like, it's like an hour away. And so then we go and we're like, but you need to look at the line, and the line's not very long. So like just today it said come back in a half an hour for the mobile pickup order. I was like, let's just wait in line. So literally we went and got in line. We were in line for, I think,
sorry, the birds are scaring me.
Yeah, there's a weird dodgy bird like coming over here and like hanging out with us.
I think he's like looking for the Pop-Tart too, I'm not kidding.
Oh yeah, we should hide that. There's another one below you, don't look, there's another one down there.
Oh, there's a few, I keep seeing them.
Sketchy birds. Anyway, and we waited in line maybe like 60 seconds, and then I ordered, and then they gave me our item in like another minute. So like I only had to wait in line like 2 minutes. So I'm not sure what's up with the mobile order here. But
I also don't know what's up with the seating, because they expanded the seating, but there's still not enough seating.
Still not enough seating,
not
right
enough
here.
At all.
They really need to open up a new barbecue restaurant that they're gonna be opening up right over there, which you can't see from that angle, but I can see it. The new Woody's Rodeo Barbecue, whatever it's called. I forget already the name of it, but it's, they're working on it, so I think once that opens up, maybe it'll help, but if it's a sit-down restaurant, I don't know that it will honestly help this situation right here. Anyway, that's a long story about Woody's Lunchbox. So, we got the fried, I don't know, I was like,
I'm not sure why you said fried that
way. I was like a horse all of a sudden. Fried Lunchbox. Here we go. Fried Lunchbox Tart.
Yeah.
That's what it's called, the Pride Lunchbox Tart. And I'm happy to say that the description for the Pride Lunchbox Tart is actually the description for the Pride Lunchbox Tart. I didn't have to go find it on another dessert.
Yeah.
So, let's take a look at this thing.
And now I feel things. I felt something on my foot, and I thought it was a bird.
It was a bird pecking you.
It wasn't. I'm not sure what it was. That's what birds do. Birds don't even do that.
Whatever. Okay, I got this weird sun thing going on right here. Let me angle this a little bit differently. There we go. That's better. Yeah, those birds just attacked those people over there.
They didn't attack them. They flew towards them.
I mean, it got close. It was close to attacking. It was in attack mode.
And like things are dropping their weapons.
Well, that's water droplets.
Freaking out.
Okay, everyone's like, what's happening right now? Can we get to this box tart lunch? What did I say? Box tart lunch. Whatever.
Lunch, fried lunch box tart.
Okay, moving on. How cute is this thing, right? It's huge, first of all. Second of all, it's got this... So it said it has a guava-filled pastry with a purple vanilla fondant on top. And then it's got rainbow sprinkles. It's got a sour ribbon candy. And a cute little blue chocolate Mickey on it. Look how cute that is. So we're going to give it a go. Does seem weird. We've had Pop-Tarts here before. And one of them was not great, and one of them was pretty decent. So let's find out where this one's at. I'm just gonna crack this thing open. Right here. Yes. I mean, that looks pretty interesting. Do you want the sour ribbon blue chocolate part? Or the, you take, here, you can, oh, you sure? Okay, you give it that part. I'll take the sour ribbon. My first bite doesn't have any flavor. Is yours?
I took two bites and it didn't have flavor.
I'm gonna try the chocolate Mickey guy here.
So did the table.
The white chocolate kicked it up a little bit. Because now I taste white chocolate. Yeah. I'm going to try the sour ribbon. A little bit better.
It's tight.
Yeah.
I wouldn't waste my money on it. It's just kind of blah.
Yeah, it's
all right. Get the cheesecake dome.
It's all right. I mean, even with the sour ribbon and the chocolate, and I got a big actual chunk of the guava filling on the inside and the fondant. It doesn't have that much flavor. The flavor that it does have, isn't that great?
Yeah.
I don't know what...
I'm very thirsty now.
Yeah, I don't know why I didn't get a water. It's the only one I didn't get a water. Yeah, I don't know what happened. I messed that up. Anyway...
Those people over there got the barbecue grilled cheese at the table over there, and I'm very jelly.
And they got the tots with all the stuff on it. They look delicious.
They didn't even eat them.
I might ask if they want them or not.
No.
I'm going to eat that. Pass it over here. Tastes better than this lunch tart here. Yeah, overall tart, not the best. I kind of was expecting that, honestly, because the other tarts we've had here just came in kind of like, eh. And this one ranks in the bottom. The one tart, I don't remember which one it was that was... which one was it that was pretty decent? The raspberry one was pretty decent. The other two we had were not good. And this one's just... No. Moving on. And this was $4.29.
$4.29. You did not get your discount at the lunchbox, which I find annoying because...
Yeah, there was no discount. I asked.
It's one of the main places to eat here, and I feel like they should take a discount.
Did we get the discount at the other two?
Probably not. We did them on the app.
I forgot. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we did.
Probably
on the
at
app.
ABC Commissary we did. I bet we did.
So, I don't know. Just not my favorite. I would move on.
I don't like this area. It's making me feel itchy and like a bird is getting me and I'm getting dropped on. Moving on.
Just a quick look at the new Roundup Rodeo barbecue restaurant that's going to be coming to the Toy Story Land. It's right behind this wall. They're doing a lot of construction here. I mean, I think it looks cute. We'll definitely give it a shot when it opens. I think it looks cute. I'm not a big barbecue fan, but I'll definitely try anything once, and sometimes I'm surprised. So no definitive date for when it's going to be open, but this place definitely could use a second place to eat. Well, there you have it. 3 Pride treats, specifically here for Pride, and... We spent about, I'd say, like $16, $17 maybe dollars for the 3 treats combined. And I would have traded it all in for 1 Mickey pretzel.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, 1 Mickey pretzel. I would have given up all 3 of those treats. It would have been a lot cheaper to just get the 1 Mickey pretzel.
A lot tastier.
So yeah, overall, I think we're going to head over to Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, which has been down all day.
and it's now reopened, and it's got a pretty long wait though, probably because a lot of people have lightning passes that have been backed up and they're using, because even though the standby line doesn't look very long, I think there's a big backup of lightning passes. Hello!
Nothing can stop us now. I'll tell you how. We're gonna make it happen. Let's take a ride and spend a day in the countryside.
Good times are here to stay. Woo! We'll get away and have the perfect
weekend. Oh, hiya, folks. Wanna take a ride on the train?
Oh, it's cold.
Excuse me, you there. Do you mind helping these good people into the cartoon while I fix this here locomotive?
Not what I expected to be doing today, but okay.
Thanks. Be back in a jiffy to pick you all up.
All right, one moment, everyone. Why don't you make sure that I finish drawing your railroad tracks? Be just a moment. They're still doing the finishing touches. Quite a bit of a smoke,
so
right?
Good.
Well, it does take an explosive force to go from 3D to 2D, as we recently found out.
Yeah, he must want to see you pretty badly to break through the screen.
It's one way to break a fourth wall. I wouldn't recommend it. Crashing trains is not high on my list of things to do. Though I guess it's high on your list. You wanted to ride a runaway railway? You're in luck for that. Goofy's your driver today. Woo!
All right, well, good luck, everyone. Go right ahead.
Thank you.
Yeah, hopefully you don't run amok, but I mean, he does work for the
And that's the day. It's almost dark here. Park closes in like 20 minutes or something, I think. We rode Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, which wasn't actually a plan, but I'm glad because it didn't take very long. We were only in line for like 25 to 30 minutes, so I love that ride too. But overall, lots of sweet treats. Only the cheesecake one was decent. The rest were just really not that great. I had high hopes, too. They looked pretty, though. I did like the colors. They looked really cute.
Yeah,
the aesthetic of them was great. They were super cute,
yeah.
But they didn't taste cute. A la, we're back to the Festival of the Arts, apparently, which everything looks cute, but doesn't taste cute. That's all we've got for today, so we will see you again tomorrow. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, comment below, hit the notification bell.
I'm Emma.
And I'm Elizabeth.
And we're from Houma, Louisiana.
The noble way
is the easy way.